The Google campus in Berlin-Kreuzberg is just another project of domination seeking to restructure the power of state and capital. Since resistance against the Google campus has begun, it's become clear that, on the one hand, Google wants to sell itself as a social organization and as not having bad intentions. On the other, many people don't know much about Google or its machinations. Google is one of the strongest forces behind the present convergence of information tech, digitalization of the economy, new technologies of control and repression, commercialization of the everyday life, cybernetics, nanotech, neuroscience, and biotech. And this is more than just an upgrade to the industrial system. It's a fundamental change towards power as domination. One of Google's weak points is without a doubt its image, which it defends at all costs. The point here is not to present Google as an evil American multinational, but rather to recognize its part in the development and refinement of domination through technology, and how this is supported by interested parties linked to politics and the economy. This makes it possible to link the struggle against the Google campus with other conflicts, like policing, surveillance, gentrification, etc. The fight against the Google campus Berlin involves various groups, and more people are starting to realize that Google is at the center of a growing system of totalitarian technological control. There is no formal group, no group identity, and no membership. Instead, those participating associate based on their affinity, even if this is just for one action. The struggle against Google has been diverse. Direct attack means attacking the campus and those in charge of it without detours. The question of legality does not arise, since begging for permission accepts the state structures instead of recognizing the responsibility for the status quo. Thus, choice of means cannot depend on the framework set by the state. Google Campus Berlin can only be prevented if there are widespread attacks against the project. There are information events, discussions, films, regular meetings, graffiti, posters, banners, demonstrations, and direct actions of all kinds. Direct actions have included attacks on the future Google campus building with paint and graffiti, a newspaper called Shitstorm with a print of 8,000 containing articles criticizing Google and the world it stands for from an anarchist perspective, unregistered noise demonstrations every month at the campus site, and a Molotov attack on tech co-working space startup factory Gorlitzer Park. Google has been trying to counter efforts to articulate this critique by throwing money at business owners, politicians, and other institutions in the city, and doing their own counter-public relations campaigns. Show solidarity, and don't let them divide us. Fuck Google.